Let's quickly get away from this noisy area. Well, I'm not actually helping it, am I? Okay, this should be fine just over here. Sorry, these crowds are so darn loud. What's up, everyone? Welcome back to the channel. In today's small tutorial video, I'm going to show you how to do a standstill burnout. So we have got a Honda Civic over here. As you might probably know, it is front-wheel drive. Then you can also do a standalone burnout with a rear-wheel drive, and apparently you can do it with an all-wheel drive car as well. I tried it just with one or two cars, but I think they're just way too powerful, the brakes are too strong, I don't know what's going on, but it just doesn't want to do it. Maybe you can try it out and let me know in the comments below. But anyway, so let's quickly go to this Honda Civic. First thing you gotta do is you gotta go and buy a new car. No, I'm just lying. We're gonna go to upgrade and tuning. Custom upgrade, and we're gonna go all the way to our platform and handling. So this is where the magic starts. You're gonna have the highest brake kit installed. In this case, as you guys can see, is the race brakes. We're gonna quickly go all the way back. Oh darn it, we're gonna be back at the noisy crowd now. Let's just quickly get away. Oh, don't bump, please don't. Okay, taking this corner quick. Just trying to avoid as much wheel spin as possible. This car just loves to spin. Okay, so here we are. So there is actually two ways you can do a standstill burnout with these cars. Remember, your handbrake is connected to the rear wheels. So whenever I just accelerate now, it will actually spin. As super easy as that. I didn't change any setting nonetheless. So let's just go a little bit further away. I can still hear the crowd there in the back. Okay, this should be fine. So yes, this is the first method, but let me quickly show you the second method where you actually change a few settings. So you're going to go to cars, you're going to go to tuned cars, and all the way to brake. So this is where a lot of people get confused. Even myself, I never realized it until I had a proper look. So how this brake thingy-ma-bob works is that it only works on the rear wheels. We can literally cancel out the front wheels. So if we take this marker over here all the way to the right, which is above rear, at first you might think that this is 100% brake at the rear. No, you're wrong. This is 0% brake at the rear. When you take it all the way to the front, it's not saying you got 100% at the front. No, it's saying that you got 100% brakes at the rear. So this is what we want. We want 100% brake at the rear. Once again, I don't know why they placed front there. Nevertheless, let's quickly save and go back. So what we're going to do now is, we all know the handbrake method, but let's quickly talk about the brake method. You're going to hold in brake, you're going to press your accelerator button, and you can actually just literally launch wherever you want. But with this car, I know it will spin easily, so we're just going to do a small basic low launch, and you're going to let go of brake, and then press it again, but very, very quick. And there we go, as simple as that, and we can do some weird kind of funny donuts. Like, what do you mean? What is this? What is this, dude? So yeah, that is a front-wheel drive burnout for you. Burnout plus a donut. Is it chocolate donut, that? But anyway, so let's quickly go all the way back and get ourselves a rear-wheel drive car. So we're going to take this M6 Coupe over here. BMW loves their rear-wheel drive. So now we all know that the handbrake is connected to the rear wheels. But once again, the rear wheels is the, this car is rear wheel drive. So we need the rear wheels to spin. To give you just a small example, we're going to hold in handbrake and accelerate. It just, it's like launch control. It just says, no, I'm not doing this. So in this case, we have to do the tuning. Going over to brake. And once again, this is how it works vice versa. So we want 0% at the rear brakes. So let's quickly save that. And we're going to do exactly the same thing. We're going to hold in brake, accelerate. We're going to let go of brake and press it immediately again. Really, really quick. And there we go. So the brakes in the front are activated. And the rear obviously has got no brakes. And we can see a little bit of smoke. Oh yeah, and something that's also pretty cool, because I know most of the people that's actually going to do this, they're going to use it for drag racing, right? So this is pretty cool. If you press T, well, this is on keyboard, I think it's up on controller, you can actually go over here and you can see your wheel's temperatures and the tire pressure. So if I have to do a burnout, you can see the actual pressure going up and the temperature going up as well. Can I go to second gear? No. Come on. Okay, when I went to second gear, the car was like, no, I'm not doing this anymore. So yes, regarding rear-wheel drive cars, I tried it a bit and I didn't succeed. I don't know if it's the torque curve that's a little bit too late or just people say it's possible. I haven't seen it personally yet, but nevertheless, before we actually go, I just want to show you guys something real quick. We're going to quickly say buy new cars. I just want to go back to the upgrade station. I just want to show you guys something. If you do actually struggle with your car getting traction, you can actually install... Where is it now? I'm going to the wrong place. You can actually install drift tires over here. But the problem is that if you have got drift tires, it destroys the purpose of using it for drag race. Maybe you want to use it for anything else, like a awesome intro to a drifting video or whatsoever. And then also, let's quickly talk about the power curve. As you guys can see here, this car actually hits at 2000 RPMs. Let's see, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. At 2000 RPMs, it's already at max torque, which is pretty cool. I can tell you guys now that this car has got like a torque limiter on it because it's just too flat for way too long. Nevertheless, what I'm trying to tell you guys is that if you can get a nice curve up, and as you guys can remember, I think when we did a launch, we were at like 2000 RPMs. So yes, when we drop our brake and press it again, it just had enough torque to keep the wheel spinning while standing still. So this is something you can also look at, and obviously, let's say your car's torque is really late, like maybe 3000 or 3.5 or whatsoever, there is another way you can counter that by changing your gears. Obviously, sorry guys, I can't change, I can't change my gear ratio over here, but if you make your gear ratio smaller, the gear will actually have more power in that first or second gear or whatever it is, which is actually benefit for your wheel spins. But whenever you do something like that, you gotta know that you might mess up your actual racing gear for your car. So it's kind of a vice versa thing. It's not so simple with every car, but it's pretty fun to, you know, just be able to stand here and instead of going forward, backwards, reverse and everything, you can just stand here and just do this, heat up the wheels, and then obviously you can just do your quick and awesome launch. Well, clearly that burnout didn't help. Thank you so much for everyone watching. I really do appreciate it. If you got any questions, let me know in the comments below. If you'd love to support the channel, especially if you're new, hit the logo at the bottom right corner to subscribe. If you want to see a similar video, hit the icon on the left. If you want to see one of my most recent videos, hit the icon on the right. And then I'll see all of you legends in my next video. But for now, peace out.